Starting a game with a quad feed makes you feel really damn good. Starting a game with a quad feed from a shotgun makes you feel even better, considering you need to be right up close and personal with the enemy to pull off that quad feed. What's going on, guys? My name is Prestige. I hope that you are all having a wonderful day. Today, I wanted to start off with the conversation of shotguns, since we're going to be talking about them in Call of Duty World War II. Now, you may be wondering why I'm not uploading World War II content, and that's because I am legally not allowed to anymore. I have used as much World War II content that I am legally allowed to until the beta, but when it comes out, you bet your ass I'm going to have a ton of gameplay in regard to it. Now, first things first, there is one constant that's always been around since the Call of Duty community became a community, and that is shotguns are more or less universally hated. People will normally say that you have no thumbs, get some skill, use different weapons, etc., etc. The list goes on and on and on, and I'm sure by this point in the video, people have already made their mind up and possibly even posted comments like that on this video here today. But for World War II, shotguns are a little more valuable than we've had in previous years. And the reason I say that is due to the fact that there is actual trench warfare going on in Call of Duty World War II. Now, directly from the build that we were able to play at E3 2017, there were only two shotguns available, the Winchester 1897 and the toggle action shotgun. Both of these weapons are very powerful at close range. The toggle action shotgun has a little bit of a benefit because it's semi-automatic, but it has a very slow rate of fire. Each one of these shotguns can be used with the Expeditionary Division, and you are also given a specific division skill, which in this case allows you to use a couple rounds of Dragon Breath in each of these shotguns. Dragon's Breath will shoot flames out of the end of your shotgun, and in certain circumstances you can burn your enemies directly, or you can get a one-shot kill like you normally would with the shotgun, but I really didn't see any major use out of this. It doesn't make or break the class in any way, shape, or form. Now, speaking more about each individual shotgun, let's start with the Winchester 1897. This is your standard run-of-the-mill pump-action shotgun. It's super, super effective at close ranges. One-shot kills all day long. If you're anywhere in the medium to long range distance, though, you're gonna really have to aim high for the head, or you're gonna have to get lucky and hopefully all of your pellets hit. Attachments will also be a thing for shotguns. So in the build we were playing, there were already attachments on each division. We weren't able to customize it or see what else would be available, but for the specific game, we were playing with the advanced rifling, which I assume is going to actually just increase your overall range with the shotgun from what you can do damage, or increase your damage at range. And to me at least, like I said, it wasn't doing incredible amounts of damage, but it was still doing pretty dang good at close range. And the second attachment was the extended mag, of course, that will just increase the overall amount of shells you're able to fire before needing to reload. As for the toggle action shotgun, there was one different attachment, which was the quick draw handle. This allows you to aim down sight a little bit faster, and of course the extended magazine was also paired up with this weapon as well. The semi-automatic shotgun, a lot of people were comparing to the Brekky, but it doesn't fire as fast, I don't believe. I think it's a little bit slower, but it also has a lot less damage and range than the Brekky. With Call of Duty Black Ops 3, Infinite Warfare, and even Advanced Warfare in certain cases, these shotguns have exorbitant amounts of range just because people are flying all over the freaking place. You have people jumping all the way up in the air, you know what I'm saying? Like, you need to have a lot of range for specific gameplay like that. But something that's more grounded, you're gonna notice the range is cut, it's severed, and it's definitely gonna have an impact on anybody who's used to playing with shotguns. It took me a couple of rounds in order to get used to the range and how cut it was, so I wouldn't necessarily say that the shotguns are great in World War II, but then again, I'm not saying that they're terrible either. They're kind of like right in the middle where they're okay, but I definitely think that there needs to be some changes to shotguns for World War II in order to make them, you know, good. I don't want them to be super crazy. Once again, we're more grounded now, so you don't have to worry about people flying up over your head. You don't have to worry about people crossing the gap in like 2 seconds flat with the specialist ability. These are things that we just don't have to worry about anymore. So shotguns are more, I guess you would say, back to earth, which is crazy to say, but I wouldn't worry about it. Not at all. As for shotguns in Infinite Warfare, I can safely say that the new favorite shotgun of mine is the Rack 9 Lance. This thing is absolutely fantastic. It does incredible amounts of damage, And it actually made me really enjoy playing Infinite Warfare today, believe it or not. Like, using the shotgun and just kind of going ham on people, that made me feel really good playing the game. So anyway, guys, let me know what you think down below in the comment section in regard to shotguns so far. Do you hate them? Do you love them? Do you wish they were just out of Call of Duty completely? I guess you can consider shotguns, a close-range sniper pretty much, because snipers can do the same thing from long range, medium range, and close range. They can get one-shot kills, but then again, who am I kidding? Let me know what you think down below once again. If you enjoyed the video here today, click the like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. And until tomorrow, my friends, I will see ya. Peace.